I'm Eamonn Linehan. Welcome to Sunday's Jazz Alley. Tonight we feature a New Yorker who became associated with the so-called West Coast scene. Saxophone was his first instrument, and then at 18 he switched to drums. A Coast Guard employee, he played on transatlantic liners, worked for jazz at the Philharmonic, and recorded with Coleman Hawkins in 1943. And in those upbeat years that immediately followed World War II, Shelly Manne propelled a couple of the most famous big bands. From 1949, Woody Herman, The Great Lie. Among the band members, Jimmy Giuffre, of which more anon, and Shelly Manne. The drummer also enjoyed a couple of spells with Stan Kenton's orchestra during the late 1940s and early 1950s. Manne is remembered for his innate swing and versatility, which was just as well, since Kenton's approach didn't always suit Shelly's temperament. By way of example, a somewhat weighty composition, Dance Before the Mirror.
Thank you.
Kenton's Orchestra from December 1951. Of course, there was nothing stopping individual Kentonites from going off and funding their own little pet projects. Here's the sound of Bob Cooper and Art Pepper, saxophones, Conti Candoli, trumpet, and, providing the vocal, Shelly Manne.
All of me, why not take all of me? Can't you see, I'm no good without you? Take my lips, I want to lose them. Take my arms, I'll never use them. Your goodbye left me with eyes that cry. How can I go on, dear, without you? You took the part that once was my heart. So why not take all of me? Take all. Are you blind? I'm nowhere without you. Take my lips, take my heart, take my babu doobie, take my arms, I'll never use them. Your goodbye left me with eyes that cry. How can I go on, dear, without you? Now you took the best, so why not take the rest? Baby, take all of me.
All of Me, performed by the Shelly Manne Septet. Shelly's father, Max, was a professional drummer. He chose not to tutor his own son. Parents with children learning to drive will immediately understand why. But Max did find a suitable teacher and arranged for a first lesson in the basement of Radio City Music Hall in New York. Shelly remembered being shown how to set up the drum kit and hold a pair of sticks. His teacher then played a Count Basie record, Topsy, before uttering one instruction to Shelly. Play. Windswept, part of the Leith Stevens score for an early Marlon Brando movie, The Wild One. Bikers, leather jackets, menacing scowls, rampant hormones and such. Shelly Manne, who played drums, would work extensively in film and television after relocating to California. The TV series Daktari, remember Clarence the Cross-Eyed Lion, was scored by Manne. He was also a technical consultant on The Man with the Golden Arm, paid to coach Frank Sinatra's scenes involving a drum kit. Suddenly It's Spring, Stan Getz, circa 1955, with Lou Levy, piano, Conti Candoli, trumpet, Leroy Vinegar, bass, and Shelly Manne. Here's that same rhythm section, Vinegar and Manne, with another pianist. Bonus points to those of you who can guess the identity. Written and performed by Clifford Brown. Shelly Manne didn't just move to California for the opportunity to work in film. The weather had some bearing. He and his wife, Florence Flip Manne, bred Arabian horses. Here's a tune named in Florence's honour, Flip. Thank you. Welcome to Sunday's Jazz Alley on RTE Lyric FM between now and 8pm, remembering the music of Shelly Manne. A drummer, yes, but a very musical one. A musician open to innovative ideas, for instance, putting uncooked rice on drumheads. That was Shelly Manne with Jimmy Giuffre and Shorty Rogers, The Three, recorded in 1954. That album's been reissued on one CD with another experimental project, The Two, Shelly Manne with pianist Russ Freeman. Thank you. With, among others, Russ Freeman and Shelly Manne. Before that, Shelly Manne and Russ Freeman, the sound effects man. Two contrasting examples of what the drummer could achieve in the studio. By all accounts, Shelly was usually good company, socially as well as musically. His sense of humour is evident on this recording with Sonny Rollins and Ray Brown.
Thank you.
Johnny Mercer's I'm an Old Cowhand from the Wacky Way Out West session by Sonny Rollins. Shelly Manne, who played drums on that album, diversified over the years. He didn't just lead a successful unit called Shelly Manne and His Men. They played in a club he ran for 14 years known as, what else, Shelly's Manhole. And Shelly was open to left-of-centre pursuits. He recorded two studio dates with Bill Evans, Empathy and A Simple Matter of Conviction. Here's the title track from the latter. Recorded in 1966, Bill Evans, Shelly Manne and Eddie Gomez, A Simple Matter of Conviction. As I said, Shelly ran a swinging little unit called Shelly Manne and His Men. Was tonight's programme with one of their finest incarnations, Victor Feldman piano, Joe Gordon trumpet, Richie Kamuka tenor saxophone and Monty Bodwig bass.
Here's a beautiful waltz we just got in the book. It was written by trombonist Frank Russellino and it's called Blue Daniel.
recorded live in San Francisco back in 1959, Shelly Manne and his men, Blue Daniel. If you pressed me to choose one recording by the three-times Grammy-nominated drummer, then it would be that album, Live at the Black Hawk. Until our midweek show with Donald, all the best from Eamonn Linehan and the Jazz Alley team. Bernard Clark's next on Lyric with Nova.